You think you flew south for the winter? This is my beach. Get off my beach.
Well, that's not very welcoming.
Yeah, Conan, the sophomore is going to make his fourth start this year. Alex Hornibrook has had injury problems for much of the year, 4.5 minutes away from kickoff, the Pinstripe Bowl, Miami and Wisconsin. As you look at this game, who you leaning? Which way are you leaning here?
I'm taking Miami, and Miami's defense came in very, very underrated, and they've been phenomenal as the season's gone on, even though the offense has struggled, but the defense can handle Jonathan Taylor.
I can't wait to see what they do. Wisconsin, on 86% of their runs, gains positive yardage against a team in Miami that leads the country in tackles for loss per game.
Wait, so who are you taking?
Wisconsin.
Oh.
See who enforces their will in New York City.
Believe in the run.
Oh.
I don't do this for the riches. I'm infected. My condition is I'm always in my head. To my religion, I'm obsessed, it's by decision. I'ma do this till I'm dead, yeah. Set me on fire, set me on fire. Whoa, whoa. I'm still alive, I'm still alive.
You're watching Capital One Bowl Mania.
Happy holidays from the Big Apple. A short drive from Lower Manhattan brings you to the Bronx and the new era Pinstripe Bowl, all part of Capital One Bowl Mania. The Miami Hurricanes and Mark Richt trying to close their season with a win against the Badgers of Wisconsin here at the home of the 27-time world champion New York Yankees. We welcome you to Yankee Stadium and the new era Pinstripe Bowl. Now, there is a reason that people live in Miami, and we're looking at it right here. In the Bronx, feels like 34 degrees. Madison, Wisconsin, a balmy 40 right now. And in Miami, 78 degrees. See how home the Hurricanes feel here in the Big Apple. Hi again, everyone. Bob Wischusen here with Mike Golic Jr., Dan Orlovsky. And if Golic Jr., Orlovsky, and Wischusen are not enough syllables for you, Paul Carcaterra will join us from the field in just a moment. This is a really interesting matchup. It's an Orange Bowl rematch from last season. Two teams that began the year in the top 10 of the AP poll were hoping for the playoff. This is a really nice consolation prize, this game.
Yeah, I mean, these are two storied programs with rich histories and great brand names. And no, they did not get the win total that they wanted this year, but they end the season in a bowl game, an opportunity to kick off 2019 and maybe see some stars of the future.
Exactly. That's what this bowl games end up being really about. And on Wisconsin's side, the future looks pretty bright in the hands of your Doak Walker Award winner and Jonathan Taylor, the guy 11 yards shy of 2,000 on this young season. And it's been impressive to watch. A guy who's going to surprise you with his speed, has the vision to go inside and find holes amongst the giants on this Wisconsin offensive line. It's a running back's dream, and he's turned it into quite a reality for Wisconsin this season.
That's a future first-round pick, and he is running behind several other future first-round picks. Now, that Wisconsin offensive line has to deal with, statistically speaking, one of, if not the best defenses in college football.
Yeah, guys, when you put Miami on tape, it becomes clear quickly that they are college football playoff caliber unit. They're incredibly fast and physical to the football, led by one of the nation's best linebacker units. And watch what happens when we get into third and longs tonight. They're gonna come after you with crazy pressures and try to force you into mistakes.
We'll see if that turnover chain makes an appearance for Manny Diaz. This is his last game on the sideline as the defensive coordinator for the Canes. His next stop, Temple. He will be the Owls' new head coach after the new era Pinstripe Bowl. And Paul Carcaterra, the mystery this week was who was going to be at quarterback for the Canes.
Well, quarterback Nikosi Perry has actually been a bright spot for Miami's offense, a unit that struggled at times, but his status was up in the air this week due to an inappropriate post on one of his social media accounts. After Miami's win over Toledo on September 15th, a sexually explicit video was posted on Perry's Snapchat account. That video resurfaced among Miami students last week. N'Kosi Perry is not suspended for this game, and he will suit up. But it's Malik Rozier. He'll make his seventh start, the senior, this season. His first since November 3rd, when Miami lost to Duke. So, gentlemen, it's the quarterback carousel for the Canes continues.
Well, it's going to be the offense for Wisconsin that's out there first, and they'll have very good field position at their own 35-yard line as Bubba Baxa hooks the first kick of the game out of bounds. So we'll get an opportunity to see Jonathan Taylor. And we'll have to wait to see Malik Rozier. And we're going to try to get the referee microphone straightened out. Alex Hornibrook not able to make the start at quarterback for Wisconsin. Jack Cohn from Sayville High School in Sayville, New York, right on the south shore of Long Island, only about an hour away from the Bronx, in front of a lot of friends and family, as Jonathan Taylor lined up in the eye. And they'll go to Taylor on first down. He's got plenty of room. And drives for a Wisconsin first down, a gain of 11. And Dan, what do you see from Jack Cohn?
I actually like his game. Now, here's the big thing for him. He's got to be very efficient on first and second down, but that's Wisconsin's kind of MO. Move the pocket around for him a little bit. He's probably more athletic than Alex Hornibrook, so I expect Joe Rudolph, the offensive coordinator, to utilize him on the edges a little bit tonight, Bob.
And that first carry of the game for Jonathan Taylor gets him to an even 2,000 yards on the season. He's got it again. And he is tough to bring down, Mike. 7.5 yards on first down.
It really is, and that's a quarterback's best friend. If you're looking for a guy under center who's continuing to try and get traction, rely on this offense. Rely on your center, Tyler Biadasz, who's as veteran as they come, who's going to make all the calls for a group that comes into this game and came into the season with a ton of starts and experience and a lot of hardware to go along with it.
A combined 189 starts on that offensive line coming into tonight. Taylor again. He's got another first down. Spins down close to the 35-yard line of the Canes before Jaquan Johnson brings him down after a 10-yard gain.
You know, interesting, because Miami's Gerald Willis is not playing in this game. All-American D-tackle. And what we've seen to start this game for Wisconsin is they're going right down the heart of the Miami defensive line, knowing Willis is out. Let's test the new guys.
And this is one of the great differences from last year, that matchup in the Orange Bowl. A lot of zone runs for Wisconsin. They're a gap run team, and they're putting it on display on this initial drive.
Number 99, Joe Jackson, just limped off the field for Miami. Although there's a tackle for loss as Taylor goes down, brought down behind the line by Michael Pinkney.
This is one of the best linebacker crews in all the country. Quarterman does an awesome job of getting through the kind of underneath the pads of the offensive line, driving through that tackle. These guys can play sideline to sideline, get up into the line of scrimmage. 126 tackles for the loss for this defense. That's the key for tonight. Wisconsin's offense so good at being positive on first down. Miami's defense great at setting you behind those chains.
Zone read to Karen Groshen. Picked up about two, so now it's third down and long.
And Dan, Wisconsin, masters of the obvious here. You see most of these situations, they thrive on big numbers. 7.4 yards per rush attempt on first down usually keeps them in front of the chains. Now at third and long, this is where Miami's defense gets its first real chance to shine.
Listen, you do not want to be in third and long. Miami's going to get up into the line of scrimmage with a bunch of different bodies. I mean, you'll see it right here. Look at all these bodies right there. There's 6-7 guys at the line of scrimmage. What's your protection look like?
Third down and 9, called to throw for the first time. Wide open, sitting in the zone is Kendrick Fryer, and he ends up in the end zone. A 35-yard touchdown to start on a 3rd and 9 call for the Badgers.
Well, that start will work for Jack Cohn. Don't get in 3rd and 8 unless you want to throw a touchdown. Great job out at the offensive line, picking up some kind of internal pressure. Cohn doing a nice job of holding that free safety and then delivering a strike to Pryor between those linebackers and safeties.
Wisconsin's got the early 7-0 lead. third touchdown receiving this year for Kendrick Pryor.
Cone did a nice job of using his eyes, finding Pryor, and how about him finishing to get Wisconsin's offense up early, 7-0.
An early 7-0 lead, Dan, for Wisconsin, and a good start for Jack Cone.
Yeah, very comfortable there. They got running the ball early, right at Miami's defense, testing the interior of that defensive line. But let's watch this safety right here, okay? And that receiver's gonna run kind of an interior clear route or seam route, but I love Jack Cone's eyes. He's gonna stare red wine to the receiver, and that's what frees up Kendrick Pryor across the middle.
Awesome kick down to DJ Dallas. Down the sideline. Out of bounds close to the 30-yard line. So our first opportunity to see Malik Rozier as he takes over for Nikosi Perry. Again, Perry not suspended for the game. He is in uniform, but he's a backup quarterback, and it's the fifth-year senior who last season was able to break Vinny Testaverde's touchdowns responsible for record at Miami. The record that Vinny set back in 86 when he won the Heisman. Rozier with only 6 touchdown passes so far this year, and he goes to the air to begin. And he throws an interception on the first snap of the game. Eric Burrell jumps the first pass thrown by Malik Rozier.
So these receivers up top are gonna run switch releases, okay? And Wisconsin sees that that's what they wanna do, and that receiver is reading Burrell, the safety. If he plays high, you wanna run by him. If he plays high, you wanna sit it down. If he squats, you wanna run by him. But here's my thing, Wisconsin defensively knows that's what Miami wants to do when they run that switch release. It's very difficult quarterback receiver being on that same page.
Just like that, it's first and goal Badgers. Taylor, touchdown.
Guys, there are 3 two-time first-team All-American offensive linemen in the history of Wisconsin story program. The last one before Bo Benshaw was Joe Thomas, so pretty good company. And
what did
good
he
idea.
Do? Did
Joe run right behind him?
Did Joe Thomas do anything after Wisconsin? Was he any good?
It was bad.
Okay.
You might have run into him once or twice.
Good player, man.
A 2-touchdown lead for the Badgers. No one has hurt their opponent more often taking the ball away than Miami. Well, turnabout is fair play as Rozier throws a pick.
Yeah, turnovers matter, but really what you do with them. Wisconsin gets the pick off the interception. Finishing run for Jonathan Taylor. 14-0 Wisconsin.
The New Era Pinstripe Bowl. Brought to you by New Era. Visit us at neweracap.com. And Chevy. Chevy has earned J.D. Power Dependability Awards for cars, trucks, and SUVs.
The greatest game ever played just across the street at what was the old Yankee Stadium from the new Yankee Stadium back in 1958. And possibly the most famous off-guard dive in football history. Alan Ameche scores the overtime touchdown for the Colts against the Giants in the 58 NFL title game. Of course, Alan Ameche in 1954 won the Heisman playing for the Wisconsin Badgers. And there's Jonathan Taylor, the Doak Walker Award winner, scoring from 7 yards out a moment ago. Let's see if Miami can now respond, down by 2 touchdowns. Bob Ischusen with Mike Golick Jr. Dan Orlovsky and Paul Carcaterra at the stadium. DJ Dallas will take a knee. So let's see if Malik Rozier can hit the reset button.
Yeah, first drive, not what Miami was looking for. We saw Wisconsin take advantage of a route on the outside. Let's see in this drive if they can get those running backs involved, because we've talked a lot about Jonathan Taylor, but on the other side for Miami, Travis Homer and DJ Dallas are as dynamic as any two backs you're going to find in the country.
I would imagine they're going to try to use DJ Dallas a little bit of a combo guy, get him some handoffs, but certainly utilize him in space through the passing game. He's such an athletic weapon.
Sliding over, who's been playing a lot of left guard for them this season. It's one more thing you've got to worry about before the play at a time where you're trying to string together some positive plays.
That time a clean snap, and Homer tries to turn the corner and gets close to the 30-yard line. It'll be third down and 5 after a gain of 8.
And not only is it like the literal thing of snaps, but Mahoney now is going to have to control protections at the line of scrimmage, something Wisconsin's going to do a lot of in third down packages. Where are we going in the run game, declaring who's the Mike linebacker, all those things. So the loss of the center is so impactful when it comes to the whole totality of how you operate your offense.
Four-man rush, a screen behind it. Homer gets to the sideline and easily picks up the first down. That was a nicely designed play to beat the overload pressure that was brought by Jim Leonard.
Wisconsin blitzes that linebacker right there. Beautiful call by Miami. You get the screen into the pressure. That's what you want to do. Get screens into blitzes, numbers advantage downfield. Really good third down conversion by Miami's offense.
Homer. Getting loose, Rozier, as he holds on to it, picks up about 7.
And Dan, this is exactly what I wanted to see. Malik Rozier, who we mentioned before, had a record-setting season in 2017, did a lot of his best work with his legs on the ground right now. And Wisconsin on the other side's no frills. There's no question who's getting the ball when they hand it off. But if you can create some doubt, you slow down, especially those edge rushers for Wisconsin.
Miami plays with some tempo. A gain of 1 for Homer. It's another third down. Third down and 2.
You know, in third down and 2 for Miami's offense, this is where I feel like they've got to utilize some motions, some stack sets for their receivers. You're probably going to get man-to-man. See if you have a way to help. You got such a young receiving core, a bunch of true freshmen. Is there some stuff that you can do to help them be a press man by Wisconsin secondary?
They bring in Treylon Gray, the fullback, and Jahair Jones, an extra offensive lineman in short yardage. Counter toss to Homer. And he's brought down well behind the line. Daron Harrell comes up from his cornerback spotter. Check that. Scott Nelson comes up to make the stop. A loss of 5.
This is a football player doing his job. Scott Nelson, what is yours? I've got contain. Good eye discipline by him, realizing Homer's coming outside. And then wrap those ankles. Homer's a really good back in open field. Wrap the ankles. Nice job of doing what your rules tell you to do, Scott Nelson.
And Scott Nelson's a guy who's been dealing with a hamstring a little bit this season. A young player who had really come on and leaned on Dakota Dixon as a mentor in this defense. And you're seeing the dividends of that season of work paying off.
A rugby kick is a ground ball from Jack Spicer that Jack Dunn is able to field at the 18-yard line. It's time now to take a look at our PlayStation Player Index. And we're about to see Shaq Quarterman as he will go out there with this Miami linebacker core. And he is about as experienced as it gets in college football.
Fantastic player. Versatility, fast to the ball initially, explodes through tackles. This is the best linebacker core in the country. I've said it twice already. I'll say it a third time. If they all come back, they will be an absolute problem next year.
First down, right up the middle again. He's got 6 yards. And Michael Jackson made the stop.
You know, this is what Wisconsin, to get into these bunch sets, right, Mike? You know, three guys to one side, and they're running basically duo. Teach me what duo is, essentially.
Essentially, you want to create double teams on the front side. It's a power scheme run without a pulling player. And so you get two, maybe even three double teams towards the front side with that bunch set, and you get to wash down the line. You get to make these bodies lean on those Miami defenders that have already been on the field a lot in the first quarter.
Taylor sprints into the secondary, and there he goes. Almost to the end zone, but he's tripped up at the 36-yard line. Romeo Finley saved the touchdown.
And this is another bread-and-butter play, running just an old-school counter-pull action. You see the backside guard tackle pulling, kick out, and getting just enough of that linebacker. Dan, you know this, with a linebacking core this athletic, this fast, and with a back as experienced and quick as Taylor, all you need to get is a piece of 56, and he's out the gate.
How about that double team on the left side by Dieter and Dietzen? I mean, I'm running through that hole for 4 yards at least.
Maybe five. I'll give you the extra.
Hand up to the fullback, Alec Ingold. And he is brought down right at the line. No game as we go down the call.
After the first series defensively for Miami, Joe Jackson went out with a left ankle sprain. He was getting taped up. He was on the bike trying to run. He still has not returned. And this is big news, too, because Gerald Willis is their best defensive player, first team All-American. He's out with a hand injury. But Jackson is an absolute beast. 14 and a half tackles for loss, 9 sacks on the season. So they need big 99 out there making some plays with no Willis and no Jackson. This is time to eat for this offensive line and running game of Wisconsin.
Cone on a keeper. He gets to the outside. Oh, he uses the stiff arm and just about picks up a first down. He fooled the entire Miami front. Michael Jackson eventually recognized that the quarterback was all alone out on the edge and was able to run him out and minimize the gain to 9.
Well, they pulled that whole right side of the offensive line, and that kind of sells everybody on that defense, and Cone's just reading the defensive end. Okay, easy for me. And I love the fact that he doesn't take a hit. Get out of bounds. Yeah, I don't need you to prove how tough you are right now. Get us into 3rd and 1, that's fine. No need to take that hit.
Great athleticism on display from the former lacrosse midfielder, a one-time Notre Dame lacrosse commit.
There we go, Notre Dame stuff.
First mention of the night.
First of many. Drink. Ingold. That's a first down as he pushes the pile for 3 yards.
But this is what's happening right now, Wisconsin offensively. I talked about what they needed to do. Establish Jonathan Taylor and make sure you're controlling the game. They're running the football really well right at Miami, right at Miami. I'm interested to see, how does Miami respond right now? Because right now, defensively, they're getting pushed around a little bit, and Jack Cone is very comfortable.
Last thing you want to do on defense is think, and hitting that big play over the top in the passing game has loosened up this running look for them.
Taylor is dragged down after a gain of about 3 by Mike Smith. Carton. All right, we'll get back to Paul Carpintero in just a moment. That was the 13th offensive play for Wisconsin so far, and they have run the ball 12 times.
They know who they are. Know thyself. They know exactly what their identity is on offense.
Now their identity is Jonathan Taylor, and he's bouncing off Hurricanes, but eventually gang tackled out of bounds and pushed back close to the 25-yard line. Romeo Finley made the stop, and once again we'll try and check in with Carter.
Can you hear me now, Bob?
Loud.
Can you hear me? Yes. Well, Jack Cone, I actually got to see him play quite a bit of lacrosse when he was in high school out in Sayville, Long Island. A fantastic midfielder, and those not familiar with the game of midfield and lacrosse, you got to run all day long, and this kid is a fantastic athlete. He was supposed to go to Notre Dame, committed to the Irish and Kevin Corrigan after his 9th grade season, so he can make plays in and out of the pocket. This kid's a stud athlete.
He's looking at a blitz possibly here, a 5-man rush. stays on his feet, avoids the sack, floats one down the sideline. Jaquan Johnson, a diving attempt, and it's a pick. The turnover chain makes its first appearance in the Bronx as Jaquan Johnson gets his second pick of the year.
This is something that this Miami defense does. Does Jaquan Johnson secure it underneath the ball? But there's so many teams on third down, they just get you off the field. Miami's will force you into mistakes.
We'll step aside, see if they take another look at the Jaquan Johnson interception. As of now, it's a pick. First appearance of the night for the turnover chain. Only 4,000 stones and 3 kilograms wrapped around the neck of Jaquan Johnson, and a desperately needed takeaway for Miami. Down by 2 touchdowns. Bob Schusen here with Dan Orlovsky, Mike Golic Jr., and Paul Carcaterra at Yankee Stadium, the New Era Pinstripe Bowl.
Dan had a chain just like that in his bag on the way over here. It was really impressive.
Didn't get through the metal detector, boys.
Quarterback play. What do you call that in the NFL? A keeper for Rozier. The quick, the fake works to perfection. And Malik Rozier off to the races. All the way down to the 30-yard line of Wisconsin before it's finally brought down. A gain of 62.
You know, that's the downsides defensively, is when you want to play man. Wisconsin got 5 guys across the line of scrimmage, played man coverage on the back end. Nobody accounted for Rozier. Scott Nelson follows the back in a huge run for the quarterback.
Rozier with a screen out to Brevin Jordan, the freshman tight end. And he dives for a would-be first down. Right at the line to gain, and it looks to be good enough for Brevin Gaines to move the chains.
Brevin Jordan's an impressive player, too, and one of the many guys they can get on the edges with and win, and that's where you want to win if you're Miami. You've got an athletic advantage over most of the guys on this defense. Exploit it on the edges here. Put these linebackers in some conflict positions.
Ooh, good work.
How quickly did this game turn around? DJ Dallas to the 15-yard line. Stop made by TJ Edwards after a gain of 5.
DJ Dallas, I'm telling you, you mentioned Brevin Jordan. Another guy that they need to get the ball to in space, whether it's in a matchup man-to-man. DJ Dallas is the same kind of player. Explosive, laterally quick, not limited to just handing it off to him. You can throw him some screens, get him out there in the pass game. We continuously talk about the young talent that is all over this Miami offense.
Dallas nowhere to go on second down. And now we'll see what Jim Leonard dives up on third down and about 6.5. This is where he likes to get funky with some of the pressures he'll bring after an opposing quarterback.
Funky is the word. You know, Jim Leonard, a defensive coordinator for Wisconsin, comes from the Rex Ryan NFL tree, where they're going to show you a bunch of different guys at the line of scrimmage. 5 guys, 6 guys, 7 guys. The thing that I love about it, he finds out what your protection is, and he attacks that protection. He's going to know that Miami wants to slide some guys. He's going to try to get a guy one-on-one with DJ Dallas on the edge.
Wisconsin shows blitz. They'll rush 4. Rozier floating one towards the end zone. Incomplete. Intended for Darryl Langham. And it will be a field goal attempt for Bubba Baxa to try to get UM on the board.
I tell you, Caesar Williams, number 21 for Wisconsin, did an awesome job there of utilizing the sideline as his friend. He really kind of pushes Cager out towards the sideline, forces him to step out of bounds. If it was complete, it didn't matter, because the physicality playing corner as a squat 2, cover 2 corner right there forces him out of bounds. Well done.
...33 yards out for the true freshman. Bubba Baxa with a line drive that gets Miami on the board. 14-3. Wisconsin's got the lead in this season. For every field goal and extra point made by participating universities, Allstate will make a contribution to those universities' general scholarship funds. We thank Allstate.
And so for Miami, maybe you didn't get that touchdown out of the drive the way you wanted to, but you moved the ball, you made a couple of big plays, starting on defense, which is where we expected, but then on offense, too, exactly where Malik Rozier needs to be effective, on the ground in this game. Give them something else to think about, and so far, early returns on that seem good.
Well, it's interesting because the game's like defensive narrative-wise is flipped for me. Miami's defensively has played a little bit more zone, and Wisconsin's lined up and played a little bit more man. And maybe Wisconsin defensively is going, listen, we're going to play man. We don't think that you're good enough in the pass game to threaten us vertically. And so Malik Rozier, utilize your feet, maybe some of that zone read, and you got to take a shot downfield. But it's good for them to get that turnover and then get some points.
And get that rushing attack working, similar to what Wisconsin did. Go over the top to loosen up those box look. For Miami on the other side, yeah, you've got a lot of big body wide receivers, but they've seen on tape, there's some teams that get up to the line, get physical with them early, and they have a hard time getting open. So you've got to prove to them they need to think otherwise.
Axa hooks the kickoff toward the sideline again, just snuck it inside the pylon for a touchback. Almost kicked it out of bounds again. Well, coming up at 9 Eastern, our bowl triple header capped off by Baylor Vanderbilt in the Academy Sports and Outdoors Texas Bowl. Get a look at Vandy quarterback Kyle Shurmur, son of Giants head coach Pat Shurmur, who needs 118 yards to pass Jake Cutler and become the school's all-time leader in passing yards. That game always live as well on the ESPN app, so you can watch anywhere.
And what a job by both those coaches. You know, Mason and Rule have done a fantastic job of winning at in places that it's tough to go win at.
Taiwan Deal to the edge, and he's close to a first down. So we've seen all three Wisconsin tailbacks already, and all three have been effective.
And we talked about, obviously, the Wisconsin offensive line is going to get a bunch of pub, but you don't rush for 2,000 yards on a season if you don't have tight ends and fullbacks that are working. And if you want to see some carnage, follow Alec Ingold around the field. Him and Jake Ferguson both getting on the edge and staying with their blocks, blocking longer downfield, ends up springing these big runs.
Right behind the fullback, and there's Deal into the secondary. He's got a first down easily for Wisconsin. And Mike, what is it about Wisconsin that creates this culture where these offensive linemen, many of them walk-ons, unheralded, unrecruited, under-recruited, certainly players, end up going to Madison and becoming All-American?
It's the culture in the room, and it almost ends up becoming like a running joke, but these guys and the rest of the team see them everywhere together. You travel in almost a herd, so much so that if you find yourself on a Thursday at a Red Robin near Wisconsin's campus, chances are you will see them five wide in a booth pounding thousands of calories worth of cheeseburgers and fries.
Very wide, indeed. Taiwan Deal for close to 6 more yards. And that takes us down to the end of the first quarter. At the line of scrimmage, certainly dominated by Wisconsin, but Miami on the strength of a 62-yard run by Malik Rozier after the Jaquan Johnson interception breathes a little life back into the New Era Pinstripe Bowl. It's Wisconsin scoring the game's first 14 points. And they've got a 14-3 lead after one. Welcome back to Yankee Stadium. Bob Bischusen here with Mike Golic Jr., Dan Orlovsky, Paul Carcaterra for the New Era Pinstripe Bowl, set for the start of the second quarter. And a domination at the line of scrimmage for Wisconsin in the first quarter. 18 offensive plays, 16 runs, and 122 yards rushing already. And why not keep it on the ground with Jonathan Taylor? He's tripped up behind the line on second down and 4. Shaq Quarterman came through to make the stop. So now Miami has forced a third down.
And one of the coaching points you're always taught the double teams that we mentioned with Wisconsin's offensive line is take the down guy to the linebacker, put him right in his lap. Well, with Shaq Quarterman, they're getting him right up by the line of scrimmage and getting him a chance to work one-on-one in an athletic mismatch against these guards. As good as they are, they can't stack up with a guy like him darting into the backfield and making a play that puts them in a great spot.
With a 5-man rush on third down. Right at the first down line to gain is A.J. Taylor. And he's got it. Needed 5, picked up 6.
Miami came after Jack Cohn with some pressure. One, I love the young kid standing in there. He knows the edge pressure is coming. Here comes Redwine, stand in there. And then how about the job of A.J. Taylor coming back to the quarterback, a little friendly. Don't let that DB undercut you, protect that ball. Beautiful job by the young quarterback, seeing the pressure and making that throw.
And a pretty nice throw with anticipation, yep, too. That ball was right on Taylor when his eyes turned towards Cohn.
Absolutely.
Garrett Groshek. And he works his way forward for four.
I think that's been the going back to Jack Cohn in that ball. I mean, we saw it on the touchdown pass to Pryor, and we just saw it down on third down to A.J. Taylor. Like, that anticipation, that ball coming out of his hands. As a quarterback, you never get there unless you trust guys. That third down play is a perfect example of how that trust happens, because there's a way that Miami can undercut that throw, but A.J. Taylor protects it.
Cohn flips one to Groshek. Blockers out in front. Tripping and falling and getting up with a limp is John Dietzen. Looked like he was ready to pave the way for Groshek out on the edge. Just fell down.
And boy, as long as he makes it back to the huddle in one piece, he is going to get a lot of grief for this in the film section. The turf monster, well, it comes for us all eventually. And it came for him in an inopportune spot, because that could have been a walk-in touchdown. He might have been hitting his head on the goalpost. Gotta imagine they need to buff that out down there.
It's a baseball stadium. Oh, something, you know, man. Something popped up out of nowhere.
Jonathan Taylor shut down at the line. That's a nice job by Tito Odedibo, who's got getting the start in place of Gerald Willis. So big number 94, a fifth-year senior, gets a chance to shine in the bowl game. He just brought down the Doak Walker winner for a loss of one.
And he started in the last three games for them. He's a guy who's seen the field plenty. The effect won't be now with Jared Willis, who's a legitimate game breaker. But when you start to get in the third and fourth quarter, and all of a sudden they've been pounding up the middle this entire time, that lack of depth for a guy who may not be used to getting as much run as he's about to could come to bite him a little bit.
Play clock down to five. Cohn with hand signals, play clock at two. Gets the snap off. It's a four-man rush. And he is just going to launch this one to the sideline over the head of Kendrick Pryor. So now here's a chance for the Miami defense. Third down and a long 11.
And don't forget, the last time Miami was kind of in this, or Wisconsin offensively was in this third and long situation, Miami came with a different kind of pressure, forced Cohn into a mistake. The big thing for Jack Cohn right now, listen, you're in fringe field goal range, so a completion gets you that field goal. A sack is a mandatory no-no. So incompletion is better than a bad mistake here.
How exotic will Manny Diaz tend to get on third down?
Oh, you're going to see all kinds of stuff. Three-man fronts, four-man fronts, six-guy pressures, seven-guy pressures, cornerback blitzes. We see a late adjustment here. That late adjustment by that defensive line is going to force Wisconsin's offensive line to do new rules in whatever that play is.
How about the run by Groshek? Close to a first down, and now a decision to make for Paul Christ on fourth down and two.
And again, so Miami's kind of stuck late. A late rotation by their defensive line changes the blocking scheme for Wisconsin's offensive line. That play is totally made by Groshek's ability to make guys miss, break a tackle, spin off a tackle in space, and it really helps out this field goal attempt for Wisconsin.
Man, and Dan, with fourth and a short two, the way Wisconsin could pound the rock, I'd have kind of been inclined to leave the offense on the field, let Jonathan Taylor continue to set a tone for what you want to be tonight.
Instead, it's Rafael Gaglianone from 41. And they miss badly. Hooks it well to the left. So Miami got an interception when it looked like Wisconsin was on their way in, possibly to make it 21-0 back in the first quarter. And here they get a stop. And Manny Diaz loves 3 points being left on the field by the Badgers. Still 14-3. Bowl week, so often an opportunity for the players on both teams to spend some time in the community. And Miami players did just that with a football clinic here at the stadium for some youngsters in the Bronx yesterday. And Wisconsin players, well, they went to the Pediatric Cancer Center at Memorial Sloan Kettering here in New York for a visit with some of the patients there. That has to be about as tough a spot for a family to be in at any time, much less at the holidays. You guys both participated in bowls. What were the player experiences like for you guys when you had a chance to get out in the community?
Yeah, they were special. I mean, you have the opportunity to not only go and be a part of a bowl game, but impact the community, realize that you're so fortunate to have the opportunity to play that game, be blessed with that talent to play that game, and realize these little kids, they truly look up to you as almost a superhero. And so it's an honor to be able to do some of those things when you go on these bowl trips.
Here's Travis Homer, and he moves the pile for close to 6 yards.
Yeah, when you come to these bowl sites, you're a guest, and usually these home cities are trying to show you that kind of hospitality, but it's a reminder, you have a chance to come into a place that maybe you don't often get to and really make an impact, and to see these guys take that responsibility seriously with the platform you have as a Wisconsin football player, as a Miami football player, to help people out is really great stuff.
Third down and 4. The Canes trying to avoid a 3-and-out after their defense got a stop. Rozier backpedaling, that ball batted on the blitz at the line, and it falls incomplete. Isaiah Loudermilk got the big paws up and knocked the Rozier pass back, and it is a UM 3-and-out.
And usually Wisconsin scheming a lot of stuff up to try and get Bond or Van Ginkle open on the edges, but they've been bringing a lot of second level pressure with those linebackers, and specifically TJ Edwards is without his running mate tonight. No Ryan Conley, who's been a rock next to him at that inside spot. You see him getting his hands up and being really active.
Jack Spicer, again the rugby style kick. Charity hop to Jack Dunn. And he's bottled up at the 31-yard line. Pretty good field position, though, for Wisconsin when we come back after a 43-yard punt here at the New Era Pinstripe Bowl.
The New Era Pinstripe Bowl, brought to you by the Capital One Venture Card, What's in Your Wallet, and Marathon, fueling the American spirit.
Jonathan Taylor, the latest in a lineage of great running backs at Wisconsin, the 4th Doak Walker Award winner for the Badgers. 4 players, Dane, Ball, Gordon, and Taylor, all as Doak Walker Award winners at Wisconsin. The rest of the Big Ten with an award that dates back to 1990. Only a combined 3. That speaks not only to those great running backs, but the guys blocking for them.
New high score, is that bad? Did I break the game?
Melvin Gordon having a big year in the NFL, too, for the Chargers. So that only bodes well for a guy like Jonathan Taylor's future.
Taylor back to work and right into the arms of Odenigbo. He lost a couple, Clark.
You know, you guys mentioned the big boys up front. They average 316 pounds per 189 career starts, but they're not just big, they're athletes. You look at the left side of the line. Dyson was a hockey player, so was Dieter. Biotis, the center, played baseball and basketball. And Edwards, the right tackle, is not playing tonight because of injury. He was actually a basketball player and a quarterback in high school, so I'm sure Dan loves him.
They're trying to protect Cone here. The pocket collapses, and Cone goes down. He lost about a yard. Mike Smith was there to trip him up. And now it's third down and long.
Starting to see this Miami defense kind of show exactly who they are. Really just generated from that turnover. And now on second and third down, they've been really good. So the last third and long, Wisconsin protected Jack Cone, ran that draw with Goshek. I would imagine we're going to see something like a screen here, an easier throw, not letting this Miami defense really win the game for them.
You're out the box.
Three-man rush, just about got home, and Cone goes down. Michael Pinckney, terrific play along with Jonathan Spider Garvin to get the pressure on Cone. A loss of 4.
And Pinckney knows that Jack Cone's a pretty good athlete. So watch him just pop out right here, and he's going to wait. He's just going to slow play. What are you going to do, Cone? Okay, I'm going to spy you. If you try to scramble, I'm going to be right there. So a nice job of him just playing the part of, if you're going to run, Cone, I'm not going to give you anywhere to go, and play that suffocating style of defense we like to play in Miami.
EJ Dallas with a fair catch at the 35-yard line. No defense averages more tackles for loss per game than Miami. They got some there. So many great quarterbacks at Miami, we couldn't even come up with a Mount Rushmore. You almost need a six of them. How about this group? This is about as good as quarterback play we'll ever get in the history of a college program. It's been a while, though, since they've had a great one. And Jim Kelly, great to see him after another cancer recovery. He is back on the sideline here representing the U. He was here for the coin toss before the New Era Pinstripe Bowl. Bob Wischusen here with Dan Orlovsky, Mike Golic Jr. and Paul Carcaterra. Malik Rozier, the fifth-year senior, gets the start today. But Nakosi Perry, the redshirt freshman, a highly recruited quarterback, he's the backup today. He's kind of the latest in a long line of quarterbacks that has not been able to live up to that lineage.
Yeah, they really have not had a guy since Ken Dorsey. They went through 20, 25 years of greatness, and they have not found their next great quarterback.
Rozier off play action. Throws an interception. Chris Orr getting the start in place of Ryan Connolly, who was out for the bowl game, back in zone defense, and he gets the pick.
As a quarterback, sometimes it's important to listen to your feet, and Malik Rozier is back in the pocket. In a little play action, Orr just drops what? Hitch, hitch, hitch. At some point, you've got to know, ball's got to get out of my hands. Once you take three, four hitches in the pocket like that, usually bad things are going to happen. So Orr doing a nice job dropping into coverage, but Malik Rozier, do a better job of getting the ball out. Trust your feet. It's first down. You don't have to force anything.
Staring it the whole way. If he didn't get it, Zach Bond was right behind him waiting for it.
Delayed handoff to Taylor. Finds a cutback lane. And moves the pile just about to the first down line to gain.
And this is where the Wisconsin offensive line has to get back to doing what they do. We've seen them get in trouble the last couple of drives, getting behind the chains. And for all the exotics of Miami's defense, it's about one thing, just getting one guy to win. That's the most frustrating part. For offensive line, you've got to have five guys on the same play, on the same page, to make one play work. On the D-line, you just need one guy to get a win, and all of a sudden, you've busted this game wide open.
Taylor breaking tackles, hit from behind, down close to the 22-yard line. That's 10 more for Jonathan Taylor.
You mentioned behind the chains, right? Like, what does that really mean? What it means is, like, you really want to be in second and six, third and three. When you get behind those 10-yard chain markers, you're in second and 12, second and 13. A good play there, 6 yards, is still going to leave you at third and six and third and seven, you know? So staying in front of that chain marker is a big deal for Wisconsin's offense. That's why their offense is lined so good. When they have those efficient plays, they have efficient drives.
Taylor again, and this time he's bottled up and brought down for a loss. Jonathan Garvin was the first came there, but he got some help from Pat Bethel. It's another tackle for loss for Miami. It'll be second and 13.
Garvin doing a nice job on the edges, kind of popping off the line of scrimmage, having discipline with his eyes, and then doing a good job of bringing Taylor down. But this is that perfect example of behind the chains, because as a Wisconsin offense, if you get 6 yards here, you feel great, right? But you're then going to be in third and seven, and this is exactly where Miami wants to be.
Off the screen to the tight end, Jake Ferguson. He gets to the 21-yard line. So it will be third down and a long eight.
This one's close because Miami comes after him with some pressure. Silvera does an awesome job. He's looping out left anyway because the pressure's coming from his right. If he doesn't make that tackle, Ferguson might score. So a nice job by the defensive lineman.
And now we've got that third down for Miami, and we've seen them shifting on a couple of these last series, trying to force that Wisconsin offensive line and Cone to communicate a little bit more before the snap and see if they can get that one free rusher off, making them adjust.
It's really been feast or famine. Wisconsin has run for 143 yards, and Miami has 7 tackles for loss at the same time. And they'll bring a big blitz here on third down. End zone throw incomplete in traffic for Cohn as he was trying to find Ferguson running the seam route at the goal line. So it will be another field goal attempt for Gaglianone.
And this challenges your eye discipline, Dan.
Yeah, here comes all these guys coming off the pressure. You want to watch this go route and this seam. Those are going to be the guys that are going to come open. The safety's going to roll over the top. You're going to have that seam and then that go route on the top. So Cohn, understand those pressures that are coming. Where's the weakness in the secondary? That's something he's going to go to the sideline and learn from. Nice job by Miami's defense getting off the field.
Gaglianone missed from 41. This one from 39, and this one's no good. Another big time stop by the Miami defense as Gaglianone's 0 for 2. After the interception, Wisconsin comes away empty. Back in the Big Apple at the New Era Pinstripe Bowl. 14-3, Wisconsin's got the lead over Miami late here in the second quarter. So missed opportunities for Wisconsin. Speaking of opportunities, though, you have one to watch like a fan all bowl season long. YouTube TV. We'll take a look at the upcoming slate of games on ESPN. Baylor and Vanderbilt a little bit later on tonight. We've got another triple header tomorrow. That West Virginia-Syracuse game could be a good one.
Especially if Will Grier was playing. But Syracuse, man, offensively dynamic, explosive. Dino Babers done an awesome job. And listen, West Virginia still got weapons on the outside. Receivers, three guys that are probably going to play in the NFL. That'll be a great game to watch.
Travis Homer brought down behind the line. He has nowhere to go. Chris Orr leads the charge for the Badgers.
Dan, it's never good when you see an offensive lineman running outside to nobody, and Devon Donaldson, who's one of their better offensive linemen, a young guy, you see right there that color flash underneath. You've got to be tracking the backer that you're pulling for there. I understand you want to pull around and be aware, but we've all got a guy to block, and when you see him undercutting and you're doing nothing, those are the kind of negative plays you end up with.
Ever have one of those moments where you look over your shoulder with a little, oh no, I guess I was supposed to block one of those guys?
Few too many. That's why I'm here with you guys.
Second down and 12. Rogeroff play action. Steps up, looks for a check down. Homer makes the catch, but he's brought down right at the line. This time it's TJ Edwards, and it's third down and 12.
Dude, TJ Edwards is fun to watch. First of all, Gags misses the field goal for Wisconsin. The first guy running out on the field telling everybody let's go was TJ Edwards. It doesn't matter to him. He wants to go play ball, but a guy that can run sideline to sideline, incredibly productive, physical player, had an awesome, awesome career.
Gags, his roommate, too, a guy that he's been rooming with since freshman year, so going out and making sure he's got his buddies back in a tough spot.
Here comes some Wisconsin pressure up front. See if Miami can handle it.
Picked up nicely, and there goes Rozier. He's going to pick up the first down and more. Takes on a tackler. Rozier runs over Fayon Hicks and picks up 20.
Dan's got a lot of those on the resume, don't you, Dan?
Well, watch. They pop Van Ginkel out, okay? And so he's going to go into coverage. It's a zone blitz. They leave the left side uncovered. Nobody's got responsibility outside. Good job by Rozier seeing it. Van Ginkel leaves, you replace him.
And as a going against a mobile quarterback, you've got to honor those rush lanes.
You're not going to find a more mobile quarterback than me.
That was always the scouting report, wasn't it?
You were nimble around the media buffet, I'll give you that. Travis Homer, oh, lost the football. Wisconsin thinks they have a takeaway. And they do. Van Ginkel in on the stop to knock it out. And Homer coughs it up. TJ Edwards comes away with the recovery. Third turnover for the Canes.
This is something that has haunted Miami all year. These fumbles by their most reliable players. Now, I don't know.
It didn't look like he ever had a hold of it. He lost it on the mesh. That wasn't anything that Van Ginkel did. You can see him right there slowing down, trying to get a hold of that football.
And he might not have had possession, so the knee down doesn't even matter, because if he never secured it, you're right, Mike, that handoff transition, the little things haunting Miami's offense right now.
He didn't have it. It looks like replay is going to just make sure. It is a game-changing play. And again, our referee microphone now is able to kick in, but they are going to take a closer look. And there's two parts to this review. A, is the knee down? And B, is it even irrelevant that the knee is down if he never had full control of the football?
Dan just mentioned the details. This is one of the things in an offense that runs these read option looks. You spend a lot of time on that mesh point where the quarterback is holding the ball in there in the gut of that running back. And in this case, when you get that lack of clean handoff,
and a
undermines
lot of,
everything.
And look, a lot of the times as we see Malik Rozier reading Van Ginkle, Travis Homer's not looking at the football. You know, when he's going to take that handoff, he's in the process of reading.
First down, Wisconsin.
He's in the process of reading the offensive line, right? Trying to see where the hole is. So it's the job of the quarterbacks to make sure that handoff is completely secured, not on the tailback.
And the tough part is now that had been a successful play for them, especially with Rozier keeping the football, and now you've got to spend extra time thinking about it. It's like a center sailing a snap. When all of a sudden you make a mistake in a spot that's supposed to be muscle memory at this point, you refocus in that area, maybe lose focus in some of those big plays.
And now you're asking your defense to deal with sudden change and get another stop.
And for Wisconsin, I know there's 2 minutes on the clock, but you're okay. Run your offense.
Taylor. A lane to the sideline. Inside the 30-yard line, out of bounds. At the 28, picks up 13.
And watch the center on this play. Tyler Biadasz, the guy who doesn't get a ton of love in this offense with some of the other big names, but you're going to see him pulling around the perimeter. It's a great wrinkle. Gets enough of that linebacker. Again, that's all you need with a running back as quick as Jonathan Taylor going through the hole.
109 yards here in the first half for Jonathan Taylor. So that is his 12th 100-yard game this season. He's got 7 career 200-yard games. So we're still in the first half. He's comfortably on his way to a 200-yard evening. He gets the call here, but it's another tackle for loss for the Miami defense. They get him for a loss of 2.5. And it's Odenigbo again. That's the third time he's been in the backfield. Well, coming up on the Mercedes-Benz halftime report, Reese and the guys will take a look at media days for the Cotton and Orange Bowls. We've now on the eve of the playoff, as we will have a national championship matchup determined coming up this Saturday afternoon and evening. Play action for Cone. Middle screen to the tight end Ferguson. Not nicely designed was that play. And it's down to about the 20-yard line, makes it third manageable.
You talk about misdirection. Okay, so we're going to bring speed sweep motion that way, fake the handoff that way, and then you're going to leak Ferguson in the middle. So you're giving all these linebackers, okay, I got a guy going to my left, now I got another guy going to my right, leak Ferguson into that screen. That's beautiful play design by Paul Christ and Joe Rudolph, their offensive coordinator for Wisconsin. Man, I love that. I loved it.
Play action for Cone on third down. Flag throw. He hits a wide open Luke Benshaw, who's into the end zone for a touchdown. Will it stand? A flag thrown back near the line of scrimmage.
Looks like it's in the area of holding, which would be unfortunate. Third and short.
Personal foul, chop block. Oh. Number 71 and 23 in a high-low combination on the offense. 15-yard penalty for the previous spot. Big third down.
Yes, this is kind of like a fire pass is what it's called. You really just want to flash fake it to the back, and his job, chop the outside hip of the outside defender, okay? So Jonathan Taylor's his job, I gotta chop that outside guy, make sure that I get him down on the ground. It's just unfortunate. Van Lanen has just got a hand on him at that last second. That's a bad break, bro, because both guys are really doing their jobs. And now for Wisconsin, it's third and forever. To be honest with you, I'd love for them to just take a shot at the end zone. Let's see if you can find Miami kind of being a little bit lazy on the back end, but protect the football.
Well, Cone's going to call a timeout, as with 38 seconds on the clock in Wisconsin, all three
timeout
of their timeouts.
Wisconsin
can certainly
first
spend one here
timeout
to talk about what they want to do on third down. And interesting how you manage this situation, because with Goglianone missing 2 field goals and missing them badly, Maybe you want to just get it to fourth and manageable and go for it. We'll see. Well, bowl season keeps on rolling tomorrow on ESPN with three more games at 1:30 Eastern. Purdue and Auburn and the Franklin American Mortgage Music City Bowl. Then at 5:15, it's West Virginia and Syracuse in the Camping World Bowl. And 24th ranked Iowa State. They had probably the most consistent Big 12 defense going up against Gardner Minshew and the mustache of Washington State in the Valero Alamo Bowl. So all three games live on the ESPN app, so you can watch anywhere.
We're going to call him James Vanderbeek for the evening.
Hey.
That Iowa State, that, you know, that Iowa State defense is the defense that absolutely whooped up on West Virginia's offense that runs the very similar system to Mike Leach in Washington State. That's the game that I want to see play out.
See how Wisconsin handles third down at 17. Cone underneath, incomplete. Intended for Danny Davis. And this is probably not in Gaglianone's field goal range on this field. This might be a punt. And it would be another unbelievable stop for the defense of Miami with 33 seconds to go in the half.
I would have liked, listen, Wisconsin really just tried. That was a screen pass to Danny Davis, try to get a completion, keep the clock running. I don't mind this from Paul Chryst right now. Like fourth and 17, your chances of getting it are minimal. Make Miami run an offensive play, kick it down there. Miami assumingly will take a knee and go to the half.
Yeah, avoid the disaster. Like you said, Miami's defense majors in causing disaster in these kinds of downs and distances.
So Anthony Lottie to DJ Dallas. And DJ Dallas faked the fair catch. It was a dangerous play. Not sure what he thought he was going to be able to create inside his own 20-yard line. So with 26 seconds to go in the half, Miami's got the ball, and DJ Dallas has something to say after the play was over. Did he make a fair catch signal? That
certainly looks like
a very subtle fair catch signal, but a fair catch signal nonetheless.
You know, I'll be interested what Mark Richt decides to do here. This is a bowl game. I'd love to see him be aggressive. Now, it looks like they might take a knee. I don't know, but I'd love to see him be aggressive. See what happens on first down. You've got such special athletes on the perimeter. I'd love to see you try and do something, get some positive yards, maybe get a big play.
Well, they have all their timeouts, but only 26 seconds. They'll run it with Travis Homer. He's got 5 yards, and it looks like Miami will be content to head to the locker room at halftime, down by only 11 in spite of giving it away three times, twice deep in their own end, and their defense getting stops.
The defense has really kept them in the ball game, and that's been the story for really the great majority of their season. Their defense is what allowed them to win 7 games. Need to make some halftime adjustments. I think they need to take a shot downfield early on in the second half.
We'll wait and see. Maybe we get a look at Nakosi Perry in the second half, who we know is dressed and ready to go tonight. Maybe he gets a shot with the offense a little stagnant right now.
Well, the Miami defense did everything that they could dealing with the sudden change to keep their team in it as the offense gives it away three times, including on the first offensive snap of the game by Malik Rozier, an interception, one of two he threw. And Wisconsin's got the 14-3 lead. Down to Paul.
Coach, Miami statistically second nationally. Where have you been most successful in the first half on offense?
Well, you know, we've taken advantage of it. We did a decent job first series running the ball, and you know, we just got to be better taking advantage of the takeaways we're getting. You know, we're not finishing, and you know, obviously we're struggling on the field goals, and we had the turnover in the red zone. There's a lot we got to do better. I like the way the guys are playing, but we just got to be more consistent.
Your quarterback Jack Cohn is making his fourth career start. How would you assess his play?
Well, I thought that, you know, first pass, the touchdown to KP, obviously that was good protection. And you know, thought he made a play down here where he didn't need to try to make something in it. And so I think that, you know, he's done some good things. We got to be better. And I think just overall, we got to take advantage. Our defense is playing well right now. You know, we gave up a couple big runs, but, you know, we've been doing a pretty good job. And, we, you know, obviously we know we're going to be challenged a lot in the second half here.
Thank you, Coach.
Thanks.
All right, Clark, thanks very much. In just a moment, it's the halftime report with Reese Davis, David Pollack, and Jonathan Vilma from Miami after the break.
Welcome back to Capital One Bowl Mania.
And we welcome you back to the New Era Pinstripe Bowl. as part of Capital One Bowl Mania here in the city that never sleeps at Yankee Stadium. It was quite a first half for Wisconsin. They dominated statistically in almost every category except the scoreboard. They've got an 11-point lead. Could have been a lot worse. Bob Wischusen here with Mike Golic Jr., Dan Orlovsky. Paul Carcaterra will join us from down on the field in just a moment. Miami, their defense did everything they possibly could to keep them in the game. They got to get something going offensively.
I mean, only 21 plays right now, Miami, for their offense. The big thing, protect the football. Malik Rozier and their staff got to find a way to get these young, talented guys. Wisconsin's playing man-to-man defense on them. Help their young, talented receivers on the outside get off press and maybe push the ball downfield early in the second half.
Now, that running game got going in the first quarter. Not as effective in the second quarter for Wisconsin.
No, we saw Miami's defense show up in the backfield the way they have all season long, and it got Wisconsin to the one place it didn't want to be offensively tonight. Third and medium to long, where all of a sudden those exotic pressures have come out, and we've seen Jack Cohn struggle a little bit. Dan, you brought it up before the game. Let's see if maybe they can move the pocket a bit for him in the second half, take advantage of that athleticism, and try and mitigate some of that Miami pass rush.
The Canes will start the third quarter with the ball. They only put together one drive for the most part in the first half that got them the field goal. As we take a look at our first half stats, brought to you by Surf Pro. 14-3 lead for Wisconsin. 220 total yards. Those three giveaways should have cost the Canes a lot more than they did.
Yeah, huge. They were very careless with the football. Malik Rozier making two bad decisions and then a homer fumble. And like you said, Bob, this game could have been even more out of hand. But listen, it's the second half. You get a chance to reset. Let's see if you can get a drive going. Plays. Open up the playbook. And Wisconsin's going to challenge you. And man-to-man, someone's got to win.
Travis Homer spins out to the 26-yard line for a gain of a yard. Kirk?
This very minute, the plan is to stick with Malik Rozier. That's what Mark Richt just told me. So, gentlemen, it sounds like a bit of a short leash for the fifth-year senior quarterback. Defensively, though, Mark Richt is thrilled. He said after that first drive, they've really been able to settle in and play some big-time defense, specifically on the defensive line. He spoke about Tito Odenigbo, who's played great in his first start here.
Here's a shot down the sideline. Laying out is Mike Harley. Or check that Hightower. And the freshman couldn't haul it in as Malik Rozier led him by just a hair. It'll be third down.
This is the shot downfield. They try to get a double move with Hightower. Right on Hicks. And that's what you need to hit. You're struggling on offense. You've been on third and longs. You've only run 21 plays this half. Here's your shot. Downfield, perfect play call and the double move. Malik Rozier has to hit that throw.
And that was the one thing, one of the few things this offense has been missing, a completion to a wide receiver.
Four-man rush on third and nine. Rozier, back shoulder attempt, and it is on time to Lawrence Cager. There is the first reception of the game by a Miami wide receiver, and it's a big third down conversion for the Canes.
It's really similar to the first play of the game. It's that switch release. Cager's gonna go outside and just use his big body. A little bit of a shove there on Wild Goose, but use his big body like a hoops player. Go up, man, did they need that from a wide receiver completion and really for their offense.
Behind Travis Homer, but a nice adjustment to the ball. He's able to grind out about 2 yards. Van Ginkel met him at the sideline.
Here would be my only thing. Yeah, nice third down conversion. I get that. I love it. But you're seeing Miami get in stationary formations and run very similar plays that, you know, that switch release again. Wisconsin, yeah, it was completion, but they were right there in coverage. I want to see them do more so it's easier on your receivers. Do more. Easier on your quarterback. Help those guys get open. Give them easier throws.
Homer up the middle. And moves the pile into Wisconsin territory. It'll still be third down and close to seven.
And a great job by Bryson Williams in the middle of that defense. A true freshman, but a guy who they said is already one of the big hitters in the weight room. 550 pounds, repping it out in the squat rack. And you see it on display there, just being able to hold point in the middle for a Miami offense that their run game is not overly complicated either. They want to do a lot of inside and outside zone. And when you're able to hold the point of attack like that, you end up with these third and long situations.
Let's watch Van Ginkel.
Watch Van Ginkel right on that edge right there. They like to kind of mix some pressures with him.
Rozier doesn't see the pressure coming and barely gets the pass away. Eric Morrell came on a safety blitz and blindsided Rozier.
Burrell comes on the pressure outside, Van Ginkel inside. It puts St. Louis in a bind. Who's my guy to protect? Rozier's not ready for it, forces the throwaway. Nice job by Jim Leonard defensively, cooking up a pressure on third and long, getting the ball to Rozier's hands.
And taking advantage of those eyes being on Van Ginkel. With everyone watching him, you're gonna free up other guys. And when that's the book on your defense, when Vaughn and Van Ginkel have been the stars in a lot of these exotics, all of a sudden, you can start to mix in some very capable rushers from that secondary.
Again, the rugby style kick. And it is effective from Spicer. It will roll all the way down inside the 3-yard line, close to the 2. Ugly but effective from Jack Spicer as we step aside. Well, during this bowl season, as college football season turns to college basketball, you can stream college sports all season long on ESPN Plus. So start your free trial today by downloading the ESPN app or visiting ESPNplus.com. Can the Canes defense make the punt by Spicer stand up and get a stop against Jonathan Taylor deep in Wisconsin territory? That's a pretty good start for Miami.
And Dan,
no gain on first down.
Dan, you know this is a quarterback. The number one coaching point down here, get that exchange first and foremost when you're backed up, but especially against this Miami D-line that wants to take chances. These are guys that are going to try to swim you on these inside run plays. Try and backdoor and see if they can make a splash play in the backfield. So as an O-lineman, you've got to hug these double teams tight and make sure you take care of that guy first. Worry about these linebackers, Quarterman and Pinckney, later on.
Again, this time he's got a crease and hurdles his way for a first down. Athleticism from the 221-pound sophomore, Jonathan Taylor.
And like they started this game right down the middle of this Miami defensive line. Awesome hole built, and then the athleticism to go up, land on a foot, and extend for the first down. You know, we talked about it a little. I was surprised at how, like, athletic Taylor was watching him on tape. The home run speed, the athleticism. I knew he was a really good back. Watching him on tape, he is a great, great tailback.
Bobbing and weaving his way through traffic here for 3 yards, met by Shaq Quarterman. The numbers that Taylor put up this season were amazing. Number one in America, obviously, at close to 166 yards rushing per game. Darrell Henderson at Memphis was number two at just under 147 yards per game. So not only did he lead the country, he led the country by almost 20 yards rushing per game.
A quiet, like, 2,000 yard season, right?
Crazy.
Just somewhat quiet in some way, just because Wisconsin was a 7-5 football team. But we've touched on it a bunch tonight, how incredible he is.
Back-to-back 1,900-yard-plus seasons for Jonathan Taylor. He's over 2,000 on the season in this game. And here he finds a cutback lane. Great vision in traffic, about a yard shy of a first down. Carton.
Dan, you mentioned the speed of Jonathan Taylor. He was a 100-meter champ in the state of New Jersey, but he's more than just a running back. A super bright kid. Took recruiting visits to Harvard and Yale. He's really into astronomy. He follows the famed astrophysicist Neil deGrasse Tyson and considers him an idol. Last Christmas, he got a telescope under the tree.
So he's a nerd. And he's 221 pounds rushing for 2,000 yards.
And that's a complimentary term.
Yes, I was gonna say, use that as a term of endearment or else with a back that big.
Hand off to the fullback and moving the pile for a first down on third down and one was in goal. Oh, I say that with not only respect, but also empathy. I mean, I am a nerd, so I am talking
I love it.
As if Jonathan Taylor's in my club.
So Are you kind of referencing yourself to be the same as Jonathan Taylor?
Yeah, I mean, minus the 1,975 yards rushing coming into the bowl game.
I was going to say, this booth has still not combined for nearly that much yardage, even with Dan's four-yard run from the first half. We're still climbing that uphill.
First and 10 on a drive that started at the two-yard line, so now some breathing room for the Badgers. Guess who? Fights his way back to the line of scrimmage. That time, Scott Patchett, who switched to DN from tight end, got some help from Michael Pinckney, and those two combined to bring down Jonathan Taylor.
And that's the kind of penetration you want to continue to see from Miami's D-line. Those are the kind of runs that make Jonathan Taylor. As an offense, we always said, if we can just get back to the line of scrimmage on every play, we're going to have a chance. Just don't go backwards. Jonathan Taylor doesn't need a telescope to see the guys coming his way. He is the master of subtle moves inside the box and just making enough of a guy miss to get forward for that extra yard or two. That's how you get to 2,000 yards, Dan, in case you were wondering.
A.J. Taylor. Out to the 34, it will be third down and three.
A much better and healthier third down situation for Wisconsin right now, really at the back end of that first half. Third and long, third and long, third and long. When you get to this third and three, third and four, with all the diversity you use formation-wise, you can maybe pop a run here. You can find a matchup that you like on the outside, but this is where they want to live. Against Miami.
Four-man rush. Oh, does a good job at first to avoid the sack, and now he goes down. Zach McLeod came through first, untouched. Cohn avoided McLeod, but he couldn't escape the rest of the Canes, and Miami gets a third down stop.
Man, Miami really defensively has started to show up. McLeod just the pressure off the edge. Wisconsin was just trying to outflank the defense, get an easy completion for Cohn. But Manny Diaz dialed up a zone blitz, brought pressure, played a zone behind it. Nobody open for Jack Cohn. Miami's defense is keeping him in this ballgame.
Third punt for Anthony Lottie, and it rolls to DJ Dallas, and he's got a wall set up. Baited Wisconsin, fielding it on the hop and gets all the way to the Badgers 40-yard line. A 35-yard return and a chance to start in plus territory for Miami.
Man, DJ Dallas kept talking about it early on in that first half, the special athlete. Sometimes on these punt returns, special players, guys that trust their instincts, will pick up a ball that maybe they shouldn't and gets a good hop. And he's another block away, but the speed down the sidelines. And this might be just, it might be just what Miami needed offensively for some energy to get some points on the board, a stop and a big punt return.
Well, he's not a guy who's been heavily involved in the offense yet. Playmakers like that, you know this, Dan, you've tried to keep receivers happy all throughout the game as a quarterback. They're craving that opportunity, and he got it there.
And now he lines up to take a Wildcat snap. DJ Dallas picks up a yard and a half. Well, the story of the first half, Miami's offense making mistakes, Wisconsin taking it away, starting in plus territory and not capitalizing. They got the first touchdown off a takeaway. Two other possessions starting in Miami territory came away with nothing. Now the Canes have a chance off of a big special teams play to start in Wisconsin's half of the field. Can they take advantage and make this a game? Another Wildcat snap. And DJ Dallas down to the 36-yard line. It'll be third down and six.
It's one of the toughest parts of football, too, is managing that sudden change if you're the Miami defense, having that thrust upon you time after time and being able to answer the bell. For the other side, for Wisconsin's defense now here, they get a little dose of that off a big special teams play, and so you get a chance to dial something up on a third and medium to long.
Yeah, but here's my thing. Howard, hey, Malik Rozier, you haven't played in a bunch, and hey, let's get him to third and six. Now go get us a first down. I just don't, it's not fair to the young man. Not that his plays warranted it, but it's not fair.
Rozier on a rollout. Throws another interception. TJ Edwards gets a hug from Chris Orr. Both linebackers on the interior of the Wisconsin defense have a pick of Malik Rozier in the Pinstripe Bowl.
This is just a young dude being a ball player, reading the quarterback's eyes. T.J. Edwards running full speed. Ball in my face. Big pick for Wisconsin.
The New Era Pinstripe Bowl, brought to you by New Era. Visit us at neweracap.com.
Some of the spots visited by the Canes and the Badgers this New Era Pinstripe Bowl week. They rang the bell at the Stock Exchange a couple of days ago, and the stock market rebounded by 1,000 points. So you know what? Bring them back. They also visited the 9/11 Memorial. They went to the Freedom Tower, all down in Lower Manhattan. And the latest interception of Malik Rozier by T.J. Edwards. So it looks like Nikosi Perry is up and warming up behind the Miami bench. Multiple inappropriate texts or inappropriate social media postings by Nikosi Perry put Mark Richt in a position where he didn't suspend Perry for the game, but did start Malik Rozier. But Rozier has now thrown three interceptions on 12 pass attempts. And the Canes might be making a quarterback switch. Here's Jonathan Taylor bouncing it outside. Turns the corner into Canes territory before he's brought down by Zach McLeod.
I love Wisconsin before the snap there, using the cadence as a bit of a weapon of its own, getting Miami to show its hand a little bit. So all of a sudden, when you run that zone and you know where your defender's committing to, you can get to that landmark, get that hat in that outside position, because Jonathan Taylor is just looking. Do I see color peeking at me? No, I'll keep on my outside track, and I'll run for a great game.
Yeah, that's a great point, because when they use that cadence, you saw a couple guys up front point, right? Hope my guy changed. I got that guy. Awesome communication.
Taylor breaking tackles. Inside the 10, close to the 5. Sheldrick Redwine saved the touchdown. It's first and goal, Badgers.
Here comes that motion again across the formation. Everybody's able to communicate. Ferguson wraps back. And Jonathan Taylor, great backs run with eyes. There is no hole. He just feels where the defense flows and he reacts, trusting his eyes on that run. Jonathan Taylor continues to have a special night behind really one of the best offensive lines in football in the creativity of motion.
And that's Sheldrick Redwine, who brought down Taylor, saved a touchdown. Redwine is still down, so we'll step aside. Back in the Bronx at the New Era Pinstripe Bowl. Bob Wischusen here with Dan Orlovsky, Mike Golic Jr., Paul Carcaterra. And watching Jonathan Taylor go to work. He is up to 181 yards rushing. He's got a touchdown run. He just ran over Sheldrick Redwine down at about the 5-yard line, and it's first and goal, Badgers.
And Wisconsin has been giving it to Miami's defense with a lot of zone running. You wonder down here, maybe mix in one of those gap plays. We talked about their duo run before, maybe even a counter and give Jonathan Taylor a nice walk-in seam in this defense.
Right up the middle. The 2-yard line. Quan Johnson, who only came back to Miami for a senior season after consulting Ed Reed. And Ed Reed said, you know what? Miami's a pretty good place to play football, and you're going to have some fun as a senior. You should absolutely go back.
Jaquan Johnson's a great player. He will be playing on Sundays. He is going to be an NFL draft pick because he can play high, deep middle of the field, man coverage, down in the box. Wisconsin's gone to 3 tight ends on offense. This is going to be a power run game, a little shift.
Counter handoff to Alec Mingold, and he's in for the touchdown. His 6th rushing touchdown of the season. So Mike Golic Jr.'s favorite player in the history of football is able to score a touchdown.
Listen, there's not many guys that the O-line wants to invite to the cookout. The rest of you skinny kids can usually go off somewhere and find some kale. But the fullback is near and dear to the offensive line's heart. And this guy, you've watched him work all night. We sit up here and marvel at this offensive line. But when you look at Ferguson, the tight end, and Ingle and fullback, they've been building a wall on the backside of these runs. And you can hear the audible pop when that guy lays into someone. That time, a lot more quiet on the way to the end zone.
Wait. Did you just say kale?
Oh, yeah. You're a big kale guy.
He was looking right at you, and he said it.
Lots of kale in stores.
He was looking at me as a guy you'd invite to the barbecue.
A kale guy.
Saturday, noon Eastern on ABC. The Belk Bowl will feature South Carolina and UVA at Bank of America Stadium in Charlotte. Jake Bentley leads the 7-5 Gamecocks against Bronco Mendenhall's Hoos, who are looking for their first bowl win since 2005. That one also live on the ESPN app, so you can watch anywhere.
I know my friends at the Belk Bowl aren't eating kale, that much I know.
Alec Ingold came into today with 20 career touchdowns on 112 touches. That's pretty good. He averages a touchdown every 5.5 touches.
Not only are you a phenomenal play-by-play guy, but also a math guy, math whiz, you know?
And
quick numbers.
All of that without the brain food of kale, able to do it off sausage and peppers.
Just increasing the degree of difficulty. That's why you are the consummate pro, Bob.
Yeah. DJ Dallas is back at the goal line, as now Wisconsin has opened up an 18-point lead with 3.5 minutes to go in the third. And this will be a touchback. Let's take a look back at our John Deere drive recap and most of the tough work done by Jonathan Taylor.
Well, started early on with the leap over defender, but then the home runs came. The big chunk yardage started to add up. The offensive line opening up holes, and then Ingold on the finish. The thing that makes Wisconsin so hard offensively is they're diverse with their formations, and then you've got to get your fits right on defense. Miami's done a good job, just not good enough on that drive.
So Nikosi Perry does take over at quarterback for Malik Rocher. He's going to try and get the Canes back in the game. And Davis, a true freshman, tripped up, shy of the 25-yard line by T.J. Edwards.
So, Dan, this is an interesting spot. Coming in the middle of the game right here, you were backup quarterback a lot towards the end of your career. This is a difficult spot. What do you need to do to go in and settle yourself early on here?
Well, big thing is try to bring energy, right? You've been flat on offense, so try to bring energy, and then you got to go trust your eyes. Right now it's about trusting your eyes. Quarterbacking is a lot reactionary, and get the ball out of your hands for some completions early on.
He gets it quickly to Brevin Jordan on a minimal gain, so it will be third and long.
Now you're asking a kid who's sat around for 2 hours in 35-degree weather, getting him into third and eight, and so do you try and protect him? If I'm Jim Leonard for Wisconsin defensively, their D coordinator, I'm coming after you. And Mark Richt, what do you do as a play call on offense? I still trust that they got weapons on the outside. Do something, either one-on-one or get a screen. Don't force this kid into a bad situation right now.
False start.
Now, Wisconsin was just sitting there saying, hey, we're going to play man-to-man. We don't care if it's third and eight, third and nine. Now, with this five-yard penalty, they might back off and play a little bit more zone, and now you have to be very careful with Nikosi Perry in your play call.
And that's an inexcusable mistake up front. You've got a backup quarterback coming in now who's been on the sideline, like you mentioned. Everyone else has to ratchet up their intensity, and you try and use cadence to help out your quarterback, and you go and shoot yourselves in the foot on that play.
Third down at 14 for an ice-cold quarterback. Four-man rush. Perry takes a shot over the middle. That's tipped and almost intercepted. Broken up by Burrell. He already has a pick. He was looking for another. And he had a couple of red jerseys looking for the carom.
They're going to try to get Brevin Jordan just down the seam there, but Burrell's going to do an awesome job playing high and then watch him undercut it. That's great safety play. You play high. Once the receiver declares, or the ball declares by the quarterback that it's coming, that's when you can drive. Burrell doing an awesome job driving on the football.
Jack Dunn off the hop and pays the price at the 40-yard line. On Saturday, we will kick off one of the biggest college football days at noon Eastern with the Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl. Number 10, Florida. Number 7, Michigan in Atlanta. At Mercedes-Benz Stadium, the Gators are 0-4 all time against the Wolverines. This one on ESPN and the ESPN app, so you can watch anywhere. And I will be down there with Brock Ewart, Allison Williams, to call the Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl. And something's got to give, as you have two tremendous defensive teams and what you have to think is going to be a low-scoring game.
Both teams can play defense. Florida probably a little bit more athletic, but Jim Harbaugh has got to find ways to utilize that zone read with Shea Patterson. I still love Michigan. I mean, they had such a phenomenal year. That defense was so good. One bad game, obviously, against a fired-up Ohio State team. I like Michigan in that game, even though there's going to be some guys not playing in it, going on to the NFL drafts. I just love the fact that you get an opportunity to see what the future looks like.
Exactly. That's been a big part of always bowl season, but especially now with that new rule this year, that four games you get without burning the red shirt that allows coaches late in the season and allows fans to get a look at the next crop of great players for their team.
Here's Chris James. Back-to-back carries for James. And he's got a first down across the 50-yard line, Clark.
Well, Mike Golic Jr., you mentioned Alec Engold is just wearing guys out in field level. I'll tell you what, man, he is a blast to watch. He's absolutely hammering guys every time he's blocking for Jonathan Taylor. This was a kid who came in as a linebacker. They moved him to fullback. He's part of a state championship wrestling team outside of Green Bay. And the question I have for the two guys in the booth not named Dan Orlovsky: how long do you think it would take Alec Engold to pin Dan Orlovsky? I'm setting the over-under at about 15 seconds.
Wow, 15 seconds I think is actually a little liberal.
I was going to say that's pretty generous for you, Dan. Yeah. I would take that as a compliment.
I feel great about that right now, guys. 15 seconds I'm taking all day.
At this point in my physical development, he's getting me at about 16, so I won't be far behind you. I'll wave to you on my way down to the mat.
Michael Jackson able to shake off whatever injury that was as he trots off to the sideline. I'd be afraid in 15 seconds he'd break down in half.
By the way, if you're playing fullback bingo at home, I think you just won off is a wrestler.
Yeah, listen, fellas, I do enough P90X.
Oh, here we go.
I feel like I could get to 15 seconds.
Eat enough kale.
Yeah, right. Kale guy. Engold wants no action.
No parts of this right now. I don't know if you want any parts of Jake Ferguson here. We've seen him working on these motions all night as well as he's flying around again.
Hand off to Engel. Yard and a half.
You know, we talked about it a little bit last drive, and I wanted to get into this a little bit. What Wisconsin's offense, yes, we know they're a run team, but they are different and diversified with their formations. But I talked about it, Mike, and how challenging they are with your fits as a defense, meaning, hey, if I've got the gap between the center and the guard, that's my fit. And if I'm a linebacker and I've got to hit that offensive lineman with my right shoulder, I've got to hit that offensive lineman with my right shoulder.
That will take us to the end of the third quarter as Wisconsin, with 249 rushing yards, have opened up a 21-3 lead on Miami. As we head to the fourth, and Jonathan Taylor and that defense taking the ball away, and their big-time running back getting it done as well. Badgers with a big lead at the end of the fourth. Welcome back to the New Era Pinstripe Bowl as part of Capital One Bowl Mania. Christmas colors atop the Empire State Building. And we're in the Bronx at Yankee Stadium. Wisconsin heads to the fourth quarter with a 21-3 lead over Miami. Bob Wischusen here with Dan Orlovsky, Mike Golic Jr., and Paul Carcaterra down on the sideline. The Badgers with 249 yards rushing, faced with second and long. And it just feels, guys, like that turnover chain better come back out for Miami at some point if they want to have a chance in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, their defense has certainly kept them in it tonight, but they've got to find a way to get a turnover off the field and see if their offense can do something. They might honestly have to score on defense to really generate some momentum for their D.
Well, they almost get one. The low snap, and Cone couldn't scoop it up and has to turn Turtle in the backfield and take about a 4-yard loss.
Cone just kind of taking his eye off of it, knowing Taylor's coming, trying to get that handoff. Miami was bringing a pressure off that left edge. Still young, still learning through this game in a way.
And the snap was a bit low. I'll own that for the center's portion of this. For Miami's defense, you mentioned pressure on early downs. They've been a team that we've seen run stunts in the middle of that D-line to try and shake guys loose. You've got to do something to try and manufacture some juice for this defense right now. If you're Quarterman, shoot gaps, take chances. What do you have to lose at this point? Mm-hmm.
Miami desperately needs a stop here on third down and a long 12, close to 13. They're going to bring pressure. And Wisconsin's going to run it with Jonathan Taylor. He's not going to get much. Very conservative call from the Badgers on third down and long. I guess look at the scoreboard. Trust your defense.
Listen, normally I would have a lot of issues with that, but Miami's offense hasn't shown you anything all night to make you scared.
Why take a chance?
Yeah, and your defense is playing so well. Play that field position game. It is a little boring if you want to call it that, but it's smart football. Punt it away. Make them go on an 80, 90-yard drive with a quarterback that, again, has been sitting for most of this game.
We hear the term all the time, complementary football. When you've got that confidence in your other unit's ability, it's a lot easier to make these quote-unquote conservative decisions.
Fair catch for DJ Dallas at about the 17-yard line. 31-yard punt changes field position, and the Wisconsin defense, they have been opportunistic, to say the least. They began the game with a takeaway on Miami's first snap.
And we've given a lot of credit to Miami's, but Wisconsin's has risen to the challenge. Turnovers, running to the football. We've seen speed sideline to sideline. They've been exactly where they've needed to be. You can tell that they're coached well. They play assignment-based football. And Jim Leonard has had this defense balling tonight.
And they're motivated. T.J. Edwards is a guy that's looking forward to playing football on Sundays. And what's he heard? You might be a step slow, so you've got some great backs to try and stick with tonight. He's been flying around making plays.
Nosey Perry to throw. Misses Mike Harley, who was wide open, heading to the sideline.
You know, Dan, I'm with you. You mentioned it before. Some easy completion short around the line of scrimmage. What they really miss, and what you saw a lot last year, was that with Braxton Berrios, a guy who could really exploit the middle of the field like that.
Yeah, just the more you could do for your quarterback to give him easier throws and also help your young receivers getting off press coverage. They did a nice job there with Harley. Perry just threw that ball a blink too early, a little conflict, bang in the backfield, but the more you can help a young quarterback early is a huge deal.
Perry on a keeper. And now it's third down and eight. Runs right into Van Ginkle and Edwards. And Miami with only 3 points on the board. A three possession game. 2 minutes into the fourth quarter. They're running out of time and margin for error. They're gonna have to try some high-risk plays offensively to have a chance.
Yeah, what we've seen on third and long from them tonight is that switch route out of a 2x2, or now in this 3x1, three receivers down to the bottom of the screen, four verticals. So Wisconsin knows, okay, that's what they like to do in these third and longs. Miami, use that. Know that Wisconsin's well-coached. Use that to try and free somebody up, as it looks like Wisconsin's going to just play zone coverage.
They rush four. Perry extending the play. O's off his back foot and throws an interception. The fifth turnover for the Canes offense. And this time it's Caesar Williams that gets the pitch.
And it's the same third down that they just had. It's four verticals again out of that 3x1 set. Wisconsin's playing zone coverage. A little internal pressure moves Perry. And eyes on the quarterback. Now, this is a bad mistake by a young quarterback. You can't throw late, across your body, down the middle. But I just don't know how much we're helping the quarterback.
And Bob just said it. You've got to try and make a play at this point. And I'm sure that's what Nekosi Perry's thinking, too, is I've got to buy time. I'm going to find someone open.
Is it a bad sign for a quarterback when two or three guys on defense are celebrating while the ball's in the air? Scott Nelson had two hands up like, you better believe that's about to be a pick. Here's Cohen. He's going to take a shot into double coverage towards the end zone. And he can't squeeze it into Kendrick Pryor. Good coverage from Michael Jackson.
How good is this by Michael Jackson, who hasn't been tested all night? Little inside seam by Pryor, and Jackson doing a nice job. Play that back hip. Force the perfect throw over the top and then get your head around at the last second. For a guy who has not had a ball thrown his way tonight to not get lazy, to not get bored, play proper technique. That's another reason why Michael Jackson's going to be playing on Sundays in the NFL.
And down 18 in the fourth quarter, you see the pride of this unit on display. Manny Diaz told us this is a pack mentality. They hold each other accountable to this standard.
Inside the 30-yard line, down to the 29, goes Cone on a quarterback keeper. It'll be third down and 5.
You know, Bob, it's funny that you mentioned that off the pick. Wisconsin on defense, guys are celebrating when the ball's in the air, partly because they know the play that's coming. You know, partly because they're well coached and prepared, and Miami has been kind of showing what they want to do. Yeah, and so as a defense, when you know it's coming, for Wisconsin, third down here, they're going to run the football. This could be four down territory for them right now. Motion Ferguson over, bring it back across the formation and lead him through.
Taylor, first down and more. Inside the 10-yard line before he's knocked out. They'll say he stepped out right at the 10.
This is what they've done tonight. They bring Ferguson over. Whether they cross him back across the formation or they have all these guys leading in this zone run as Ferguson leads the way, then Ingold leads the way, and Jonathan Taylor showing off that vision again, picking his spots, finding his hole, and then exploding through it.
Not to be outdone either by his counterpart in the fullback group, Mason Stocky there, taking two on that play, running right into one, bounces off of him, and he goes looking for more work right there. That's just the mentality. And then Jonathan Taylor, the reason guys like this are so much fun to block for is because they make you right in space. He's going to get a defender to lean. He's going to slow up just enough, make a miss.
Here he is again, this time driven back by Jaquan Johnson. But Jonathan Taylor with that last carry went over 200 yards for the 8th time in his career. This is his 27th career game. He's got over 100 yards 22 times. And now he's got over 200 yards 8 times.
Sophomore. A lot of ball left.
Through his first 2 years of college, coming into this game, an NCAA record 3,966 yards. The only other guys even over 3,500 in their first 2 years in college, Ron Dane and Herschel Walker. How's that for company?
Pretty good. Play action. Cone on a rollout and a walk-in. Another Wisconsin touchdown.
Is a shot play, does it not?
That's a tutty. That's a shot play. Let's push the ball downfield with the naked. How about the play design, though? Last drive, shift into formation, little reverse out handoff. This time, same formation. Let's fake that handoff, and let's get Jack Cone on the edge. Wisconsin takes a huge lead.
ESPN celebrating 150 years of college football.
If you're a college football fan, not only do you like Bucky Badger, but with a 28-3 lead for Wisconsin over Miami in the New Era Pinstripe Bowl, get ready in 2019 for some of the archival programming that we've got coming to celebrate the history of college football. There is some amazing stuff that we are all, as college football fans, going to get to watch put together next year.
I think the great thing is there's generations that don't know of some coaches of the past that they were incredible coaches. So the education of that is going to be awesome for college football fans.
First kickoff return opportunity for DJ Dallas. And he's got nowhere to go. Barely gets across the 10-yard line. And ESPN and the ACC will be bringing you the ACC Network next year in August. 15 universities, one network. Visit getaccn.com to learn more. All right, Nicosi Perry, now you're down 28-3. Probably the coldest temperatures you've ever played football in. You got the ball at the 10-yard line.
Good luck.
Liam Neeson on the line.
He said it a little bit better.
He got close.
Quarterback draw. Nice run by Nikosi Perry. He takes the contact out close to the 26-yard line before he's turned back. Gain of 16.
I think I actually heard a linebacker yell the heat down on the field. That was a shot at the end of the play. And I like this call because it's something that you know Perry does well and he's comfortable with. And that should be the conversation right now. What do you feel comfortable running, going out on the field? But you also need to tell him to get down because you don't want him walking out of that game with any sort of extra shot lingering into his offseason.
Who was wide open, and Perry just couldn't reach him, almost threw a pick to Scott Nelson.
They really want to try to get these three levels. You see receivers crossing the formation. It's not there. Don't make a mistake. I honestly believe that this next 10 minutes, as we see Pope streaking down the field, but Nikosi Perry wasn't able to get his feet set, nothing on the ball. These next 9 minutes for Nikosi Perry are a big deal. I truly believe that hanging in 2019, like, this is your chance to finish out this season the right way. Show us you got a chance to be our guy in 2019. These 9 minutes matter to you.
Another quarterback draw. And this time, right at the line of scrimmage, Nikosi Perry is walloped. Might have lost a half yard. Now it's third down and long.
And one thing we talked about earlier that makes it even tougher on a young quarterback coming in right now, who's usually your security blanket as a quarterback coming into the game? Your center. Your starting center's out tonight. So you've got Corey Gaynor, who's a backup, sliding into that spot. You've seen in the last few plays some confusion in the middle between the running back and the offensive line about who they're picking up. And so you've got a young quarterback being moved off of his spot because the group around him is in flux just as much as that position right now.
You see Perry up at the line of scrimmage right now. There's lack of communication. There's a little uncertainty. Now, Wisconsin's giving you a lot to look at, right? There's five guys up at the line. But there is definitely a lack of communication right now.
Blitz off the edge and the pocket collapses. Andrew Van Ginkle gets the sack.
A lot of times when defenses put five guys up in the line of scrimmage, there's a reason. They get five guys across. Where's Van Ginkle? Find the matchup that you like. That's what Jim Leonard wanted to do. I'm gonna put five guys up in the line of scrimmage. I wanna get Van Ginkle one-on-one with Navon Donaldson. That's the matchup I like, and you go win your one-on-one matchup. Nice design by Jim Leonard, and great job by Van Ginkle of taking advantage of that matchup.
Nearly a blocked punt. Spicer gets it away, done. Scoots underneath the arms of a couple of tacklers and saves some field position for Wisconsin. In command midway through the fourth.
The New Era Pinstripe Bowl, brought to you by New Era. Visit us at neweracap.com. And Boost Mobile. Boost makes it easy to switch. Switching makes it easy to save.
The New Era Pinstripe Bowl has produced some fantastic finishes. All of these champions, winners of one-score games, including Penn State and Duke, that beat Boston College in 2014 and Indiana in 2015, respectively, both in overtime. But this game has been dominated by Wisconsin. Their defense has taken the ball away. Their offense has owned the line of scrimmage and time of possession. Bob Wischusen here with Dan Orlovsky, Mike Golic Jr., Paul Carcaterra. Down on the sideline, and now it's a little past the midway point of the fourth quarter. And shockingly, Wisconsin's got the ball near midfield with good field position.
And they're in a tight formation, and they're probably gonna run the football here.
They don't hide their intentions much, do they? Here's Tywan Neal. And he's close to a first down and gets a little help from his friends. The pile still moving. A rugby scrum for 14 yards.
Tywan Deal, one of four backs in this backfield who average at least 6.3 yards a carry. And you see why here now, a chance late in the game with fresh legs to come in and try and really lean on these guys. And this is the wonderful part of the game. This is hog heaven. This is 4 minute offense. The clock might say 6:50, but you are trying to milk this for all it's worth if you're Wisconsin. And if you're the O-line, this is your chance to break people.
It's even reflected in Jonathan Taylor's numbers. Jonathan Taylor averages 7 yards per carry, 8.5 yards per carry in second halves, 9.5 yards per carry in fourth quarters and overtime. What does that tell you? It tells you that that offensive line just wears you out at times, and that's five more right up the middle for Deal.
And I've kind of said this tonight about Wisconsin. The thing that I love about them the most is they know who they are. They're unafraid of their identity. They don't run from it, but they have found ways to get creative. It is old school ball with a new school kind of spready, motion-y feel to it that they get angles, they create leverage, and it allows their run game to dominate.
And Scott Patchen, the latest to get injured, will step aside. Jonathan Taylor has run for 205 yards. 7.6 yards per carry against Miami. And stunningly, guys, that's just a shade over his yards per carry average for the season. He's basically right on what he normally does.
And we've seen a little bit of everything. We've seen vision. We've seen physicality. We've seen finish. We've seen the ability to hit that home run downfield. I mean, when you talk about complete backs, guys that can do it all, he's absolutely one.
And he is tonight's Capital One player of the game.
Understandably so. When you talk about a lot of these great backs, you just mentioned it, when we think of Saquon Barkley, who's running wild in the NFL right now, what always impresses me is their balance. When you get in those tight quarters and you're getting hits from all sides and they still manage to stay with their legs under them and keep moving forward, it's really incredible.
In today's NFL, though, how much does he have to produce and prove during his Wisconsin career on ability to catch the ball? He's only got 8 receptions this season. You never see them throw him the ball. Are there any great running backs in the NFL these days that don't play a large role in the passing game?
It depends on the offense you go into, but it certainly has grown. That role has grown. The third down back has become more of a first down back in the NFL. We don't know if he can't, though. It's just not their style.
Here's Tywan Deal, about a yard shy of a first down.
I mean, you only have to look so far as his, you know, fellow Badger alumni in Melvin Gordon.
Yeah.
I mean, he's not a guy who's featured prominently in a way a lot of these other guys are, split out in those formations. There's sometimes, but a lot of screens and such for him. But again, came from this same offense, and we see when you're allowed to, sometimes Dan's right, you just need the opportunity to show that's part
of it. And listen, the NFL is always looking for guys that are big, fast, can run, break tackles, productive, great vision. I mean, the guy's a total package.
You can find a place for that, huh?
Someone's going to choose to pay him at some point.
Tywan Deal, first down. Let's go down to Carton.
You know, gentlemen, Melvin Gordon's junior year, his final year at Wisconsin, the knock on him from everyone who was evaluating him was, can he catch the ball? And Mike Golic Jr., you mentioned he's heavily involved in the screen game. Wisconsin might not use their running backs that way, but don't just chalk it up that they can't do it. Jonathan Taylor has morphed and changed every time he's had to play the sport of football. I mean, he came from a smaller school in New Jersey. A lot of people thought he couldn't even play at this level. He was recruited by Wisconsin, Rutgers, Harvard, Yale, but really an under the radar recruit. So just because it's not being done doesn't mean they can't do it. And these guys are great athletes that can morph and change.
Here's Chris James getting a push down to about the 22-yard line.
That was actually one of the points that offensive coordinator Joe Rudolph brought up to us, was he was amazed at how seriously Jonathan Taylor takes improving during the season, takes taking care of his body, doing the extra things to try and improve and grow during the year, when most guys, especially in college, Daniels, are trying to just tread water or trying to stay at that level because you don't anticipate making gains. He's not satisfied with that.
And he's also a kid who had almost 300 carries this year. I mean, so you learn how to take care of your body and you learn, what are my strengths? What are my weaknesses? The good thing, Wisconsin's got a big-time NFL pipeline. He's going to have so many older guys coming back and helping him with that process.
Chris James, another first down. before that carry, Wisconsin was at 311 yards rushing in this game. So add on about eight more, they're up to 319 with a first down inside the 15-yard line.
And we've talked about it, right? We have heaped praise and worthy of it to this Miami defense. There's not a lot of teams that do that to Miami's defense. It is impressive to see in person how Wisconsin just owns the line of scrimmage.
And the only Power 5 team that Wisconsin trails in rushing the football yards per game is triple option Georgia Tech. Like, that's the company that they're in.
Here's James again. This time going down behind the line. This is a much different game than these two teams played last year in the Orange Bowl, a game that Wisconsin won 34-24, but was much more wide open. There were many more big plays in that game. And Miami was able to answer a lot of the offensive possessions Wisconsin had in that game, but just too many turnovers for Mark Richt's team today.
Yeah, it'll be interesting because you're going to walk away from this game, Wisconsin, feeling pretty good. Both offensively, you've got some guys back. Both defensively, got a bunch back. Jack Cohn had a nice night. And then for Miami, you're going to walk away going, what's happened? And where are we? And how do we answer the questions that surround us right now?
Jet sweep, Aaron Cruikshank. Dives inside the five. And it's good for a first down. And if Wisconsin simply wanted to take a knee at this point, they could.
Wisconsin being diversified with their formations again. The jet sweep to Cruikshank, get him on the perimeter, get Ben Shaw leading the blocker. And that's what they've done all night. It's been really impressive. They haven't gotten into a gajillion formations, but everything, they've got one formation, three plays out of it. Another formation, four plays out of it. And everything looks the same. That's the challenging part to the defense. They present themselves in multiple ways and have different variables that they can attach to it.
And when we talk about, you've referenced it, these modern offenses in the NFL, that's the key, is making the complicated simple in actuality.
Taiwan Deal. A push towards the end zone. No signal as of yet. And just shy of the end zone, Deal is stopped by the Canes. Fans, check out the ESPN app for the postgame trophy ceremony presented by Capital One. That is immediately following the game.
Got to be a pretty cool moment for Jack Cohn. Kind of coming back home. Was he anticipating getting the start or not? With Alex Hornibrook being a little banged up. Nice performance by him playing again against an awesome Miami defense.
Playing within himself. You talked about the springboard into the offseason. That's a great point to grow off of.
It looks like Deal may have found the end zone on this carry with 13 seconds to go. And it is a touchdown.
It's kind of that old school wishbone formation. And just a straight cross block by those two wishbone guys to protect the edges. And then Beal with the finish.
Not something you see in college football. I have to admit, something I wish I would see more in college football. Take a knee. It's 28-3. There's 13 seconds to go in the game. You've proved your point. You're at the 1 yard line. Victory formation. In the NFL, that's taking a knee.
My only caveat would be Deal's a fifth-year senior. Maybe you're trying to get him in the end zone, send them off the right way.
Now you're way too sentimental.
Christmas season.
Adds the point after. Wisconsin pouring it on with 8 seconds to go. It's time for a look at today's clutch delivery brought to you by Chipotle. And it has been takeaways that have delivered the ball over and over again by the Wisconsin defense guys to their offense.
It started early on, first play of the game, and it's been the story of it all evening long. That secondary has been all over Miami. They've created some pressure, forced some bad decisions. It's been an impressive performance by with this Wisconsin defense, and it's led by that guy, TJ Edwards, right? Sent him off the right way. He's had a remarkable career. sent him off the right way this evening.
Absolutely. The Big Ten's active leader in career tackles and a guy who we know could have maybe gone pro last year but decided to come back. Him and Ryan Connolly, who wasn't out there with him tonight, but Chris Orr, who they consider one of the starting three in that middle, both showed really well for themselves tonight. TJ's been a hell of a leader for this defense.
DJ Dallas on the return. Now to the 20-yard line. The clock goes to zeros. And Paul Christ's team, in convincing fashion, 35-3, champions of the New Era Pinstripe Bowl. Let's go down to Paul.
Coach, Jonathan Taylor goes over 200 yards. Your offense rushes for over 300. Describe your run game tonight against a great Miami defense.
You're right. It's a heck of a defense, and I'm proud of the way our guys competed. And I thought we did a great job, obviously, running the ball. But defensively, you know, the takeaways, this is a great team game, right? It takes everyone, and a lot of guys contributed, and I'm proud of that.
You look up at the scoreboard, 35-3. Your defense was amazing tonight. What allowed that unit really to click?
Well, I think they played together and certainly did a good job stopping the run. They got two good really running backs, and then we were able to be opportunistic. And actually, we had a couple other opportunities of getting some, so they played good team defense. A lot, you know, defensive staff put together a real good plan that our kids understood, and they went out and executed. They played.
Fifth straight bowl win for the Badgers. Congratulations.
Thanks so much. Appreciate it.
Well, when Wisconsin is at their best, they do what they did tonight. They took the ball away on defense. They ran for 333 yards, and they win going away. 35-3 is your final. For Mike Golic Jr. and Dan Orlovsky and Paul Carcaterra, I'm Bob Wischusa. Thanks for watching. So long from the Bronx. It's time for Adnan Burke and Jesse Palmer. Let's head back to the studio. It's the college football scoreboard. Adnan.